Here is something you may not have known, which is quite interesting. Were you aware that those who ascribe an age of the earth apart from the Bible's documentation keep saying they had it wrong and keep changing that age? And did you know that time after time, their alleged miscalculations have been in the same direction? The statistical improbability of scientific error ending up in the same direction over and over like this is overwhelming. So apart from the wolf crying, "No, believe us, this time we've got it right," loss of credibility, what driving motive does this behavior reveal to us? Why the desire for a huge amount of time? Again, we are seeing psychology employed in the making of a claim that isn't true, that life was not created by God, but made itself. In this instance, it is around evolution being very, very gradual, evolution utilizing massive amounts of time. I remember first hearing of the theory of evolution, parroted by a classmate, as it were, an immoral willing vessel embracing sex and violence already in fifth grade. My grade school intellect was sufficient to recognize that things don't make themselves. His reassurance to my doubt? It happened very slowly. Over coming years, I would hear this to also be the explanation for why we don't see evolution happening, that it is too slow to witness. Again, even my grade school mind was unable to, uncritically accept there being some ready words to fling back in response. Really? It happened slowly? That's it? This is psychology. Yes, we've all heard that Rome wasn't built in a day. And how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. We know that large possible tasks are achieved little by little. But what does that have to do with impossible things? How does a man bench press 90 tons and jump over the Gateway Arch? Oh, a little at a time. How does one walk through walls and teleport themselves to Mars? A little at a time. This is impertinent nonsense. It is a divergence from beginning to ponder what is being claimed. It is a psychological lie recognition shutdown mechanism. The massive time explanation is illogical and misapplied outside the realm of the fallacy it needs to address. And on top of that, it would not equate to slowness and gradualness anyway. Why do people not realize this? The best way I know to show why is by analogy to an interview question I was once given. Hewlett-Packard had a reputation for killer technical interview questions, and this one was posed to me. If you put a steel band around the equator, spliced 12 feet into its length, and kept it concentric about the Earth, could you crawl under it? What do you think? Most of their top-scoring college-educated engineering applicants would fail this question by answering no. They felt the increase in length added was minuscule, and therefore the amount the band rises would also be minuscule. Millimeters, nanometers. This was an emotional response that came from being impressed by the magnitude, large or small, of something. They would shut down their reasoning and not deal with quantities in their pertinent perspective. They would do the equivalent of evolution believers who with glazed eyes go, "Wow, in that much time, I guess anything could happen." If you take a moment to actually analyze this problem, it is a simple calculation. Circumference is equal to 2 pi times radius. Change in circumference is equal to 2 pi times the change in radius. Therefore, if the circumference changes by 12 feet, the radius changes by about 2 feet. Can a person crawl underneath 2 feet? Yes, they can. Is 2 feet minuscule compared to the radius of the Earth, compared to the 20,924,640-foot radius of the Earth? Absolutely. Is the millimeters or nanometers emotional, incorrect answer of applicants universally minuscule? No, nothing is universally minuscule. Our sun would fit 900 times across the diameter of the star Betelgeuse. A little micron is 10,000 hydrogen atoms long, or 100 DNA molecule widths. So speaking of the DNA molecule, let's apply this analogy now. The DNA molecule, the code in every one of our cells, how to manufacture, maintain, and operate the human body, is 6.4 billion base pairs, or binary letters long. Evolutionists don't claim that life was evolving as long as the Earth has been around, but let's make that big roundup, benefit of the doubt, simplification. So this supposedly enormous 4.5 billion year age of the Earth, how does it compare to the instruction it must explain the existence of? Easy math. 4.5 billion years divided by 6.4 billion letters is every 8.5 months, many, many random point mutations occurred and failed, but finally one succeeded and was locked in by the organism dying less relative to matured organisms without the new letter, until the new letter was propagated to all humans around the entire planet such that all now have it and none don't. Every 8.5 months, all that. Every 8.5 months, a new letter added. This is the minimum average rate that the genome is supposedly writing itself. If you are 20 years old, in your lifetime, 28 new letters were added throughout the human genome around the entire planet. But you missed them. You didn't get them, right? How did you get them? If you are 40 years old, 57 new letters were supposedly added to the genome in your lifetime, but you missed them. If you are 60 years old, 85 new letters were supposedly added to the human genome in your lifetime. Is this slow? How could anybody think that evolution is slow so the theory is believable? An emotional psychological trick. That is why so much time.